It's a family affair this afternoon, so please feel free. Eat whatever you want, drink whatever you want. But this is a swanky place in VI, so they're going to serve you some things you may not have seen before, some very fancy food. Please, if you insist on eating things you don't know, at least ask before you eat. Ask the waiters, what is this thing called? So that at least when you get home and they ask you, Kileje, you'll be able to tell them, stop behaving like Yoruba people. Daddy Kileje, me oma, kini kafufu ba, ni wan kacho kule tisipokwe, buya baba. Stop doing things like that. So that in case something goes wrong, although nothing will go wrong, and they ask you what you ate, at least the doctors will know what exactly, they'll be able to trace it. What have you eaten today? Me oma, only gungu ba, ekwele, ni wan kacho kule tisipokwe. Ask. Be able to tell them that I had a chocolate for Groa or any of those things. We only have one announcement and advice. Before you start drinking, please note that is the way you came in, is also the way you are leaving. That's the entrance. Oh no, bye bye, Mo. Because when people drink now, they start to insist. Please stand up to your feet, ladies and gentlemen. And as they walk to their seat, please put your hands together for Mr. and Mrs. Kofi Dowunoel at 40. Please put your hands together. Well, you can do better than that. Ah, Asha ti bo yin lo so yin. Ah, eti mo mi obe na o pele run. Ah. Iwo na down. Ah, awon guest e won fe pa te won pupo. Mr. and Mrs. Kofi. You do know that for. See what? You do realize so. And all of you have been co-opted as ex deputy MC. Your man, I don't know. So not be someone I'm pushing on for this.
Yes, I run the one run comments.
Not be wrong, just stay for here. All right, please sit. Ladies and gentlemen, don't sit yet. It's the Kofi and his wife. We will take the opening prayer at this moment. I'd like to welcome Mrs. Johnson to the microphone. Please put your hands together for Mrs. Johnson as she leads us in the opening prayer.
We are grateful because of your loving kindness, because of your mercies, because it is by ordination that we are here gathered together today to celebrate with your son, because you told us in your words, you said we should number our days that we might apply our hearts unto wisdom. Lord, even as your son numbers his day today, I am praying, oh God, that the necessary wisdom you will give to him in Jesus' name.
Prayer simply means communication between man and God, true or false? True or false? Yes, that's what prayer simply means. But do you know that Nigerians have actually turned prayer to be quarrel between man and God? No, honestly, have you heard some people pray, you think they're actually quarreling with God? Because it annoys me when you enter some churches and you hear how they pray and it's like they're quarreling with God. I was at Benin, that was last year for a program. This is true life story. And I got into the church and the pastor, I heard the prayer point. The man of God said, please, everybody, stand up. We stood up. He said, bring out your gun. I noticed everybody positioned their hand. He said, are you ready? We said, yes. He said, cock your gun. We heard crack, crack. Now, they were doing it with their mouth. Crack, crack. I said, what is happening here? The man of God said, are you ready? He said, yes. He said, now, locate your enemy. People started looking for their enemy inside the church. The man of God said, are you ready? He said, yes. He said, open fire. I heard with their mouth. So as they were shooting, I was watching. As they were shooting, two militants, they were walking past the back of the church. And of course, you know those people, they love the sound of gun. They enjoy it. Two militants. So as they were passing, they heard the gunshot. The other man said, boy, then they shoot inside church. He said, hey, are they here now? He said, make me enter. Two of them walked inside the church. As they entered, the ushers welcomed them. That was the point the pastor said, we want to continue with this prayer point tomorrow. Please prepare yourself and come. Two militants. The other one said, sir, you are one, two souls. We are coming. The next day, one entered with AK-47. The other one entered with pump action. They sat at the back. They didn't know. Ushers were not observing. They sat at the back, watching. Now the pastor was talking and talking. They said, pastor, everybody stood up and did their hand like this. This young man brought AK-47. Face front. The man of God was closing his eyes. He didn't know what was happening. He said, are you ready? Say yes. Say, cock your gun. People did crack, crack with their mouth. The man of God heard the real thing. He heard.
He said, hold on, don't shoot. Hold on, don't shoot. Hold on. Cock your gun again. I want to be very sure that you are ready. People did crack, crack. This time around, he heard something terrible. He heard crack. Something told him, he said, young man, open your eyes. When he opened his eyes, he saw AK-47 facing his head directly. The man of God laughed. He said, people, drop your weapon. The weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal, but they are mighty to the pulling down of strongholds.
Mr. Seyi Akinwumi, please put your hands together for him as he comes forward. You can do better than that. We are family, all of us, so all this coming of not...
Hello, everyone. It's a real pleasure to be here today. First of all, because Kofi is somebody very dear to my heart. And secondly, I can say that, you know, I was here with the stars. I just finished watching a 30-minute piece on TV before I left to my dad. He's here again. So obviously, it wasn't a live program. I didn't watch you, that channel was not on. So, but I apologize that I have to dash off. I came in late and it's not really fair for me to be the first on the microphone, but I have to move my flight till today because of Kofi's birthday and I have to go to the airport. Kofi is he's like a younger brother to me. He actually used to live in a block of flats where my mother lived. And I was a bit worried at first that, you know, this comedian fellow now, he won't let my mother sleep. Sometimes he didn't. But the truth is that when he was leaving, my mother said to me, you know, that's my best neighbor has gone now. What do I do? And that just shows you the kind of person he is. He's a man after my heart. When she was having her 70th birthday, he was the MC.
By the grace of God, we will see going a long way. 40 years today is a milestone. And then in his own way, he has decided to mark it with the launch of a book. Beauty of the Beast, the scars that made me a star.
And I thought Kofi was 45, like me. I mean, when he told me he was 40, I was like, oh, let's just accept that he's 40. Because, no, you people will just be misconstruing my statement. I didn't say he looks 45. I said I thought that he's, because he's mature, like, very, very, you get, his IQ is, you know, so I just want to say, I've not had the opportunity to tell you before, but when I was starting, if those few minutes you used to stand by the corner, those kinds of supply must stay with me to do, I really, really, really appreciate them. I'm so grateful. And one day you'll be taller than me. You can follow me.
So, you want some lunch?
I'm not launching, you know. Oh, sadly, I'm not moving. You know, I didn't know my company will pay. So, my poor, my wife, you know, and then she found me pay our lunch. Because, oh, we got a lot of help. Although, I bet she almost still left. But, because that we are now, you don't know your neighbor, you don't know your enemy. Come on, you know, come on, you have 62 things. Wow. Well, the BFC won't hear what they want. They won't talk to me because we don't pass from them.
Now we're going to sing the birthday song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Happy
birthday, dear Kofi and Kofi. Happy birthday to you.
Now let's go to God.
Cheers. Now come around and clean glasses and cheers. 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 Cheers